All right, we're back for the finals. We are on the draw. I'm gonna keep this hand. And yeah, probably I'm gonna take a mountain here. Not sure. He might have gone to 6 also. Now with this Drake, I might want to take the swamp. Let's see what is the next draw step. Also, what archetype is he playing? I can dismember that. No, I don't think I do. Yeah. I'd rather just... I think I'd rather just play Nest Invader here and block. And in case you wanna play something like... a brute force, I will be happily casting the dismember. Selesnya Guild Mage. And it doesn't attack, that makes sense. Here I'm gonna cast the Rampangru to take a mountain. Yeah, Burst Lightning is more important than the Drake right now. And now if he attacks, I will be happy to block with Nest Invader. I will pump Selesnya Guild Mage and I will kill the Burst Swift Blade and then the Selesnya Guild Mage with Burst Lightning. Yeah, block this one. Take less damage. Mirror Entity, I mean, it's a, at least it's a card that I can play. Alright, we cleaned the board. Now hope to draw land to play Ethersnipe on his blocker. Sorry, blocker or creature. Sunspear Shikari, it's fine. Land. The Miracodot, it's not the worst. Here I can just bash for 10. Wow, just to block. Huh. Yeah, the point is that, am I playing around Gutshot or no? So if I'm not playing around Gutshot, I just top 5. It's gonna like Burst Lightning this, and I deal him 5 damage. Yeah, hope he doesn't have Gutshot. Oh, he just jump blocking? This doesn't make any sense, right? If he has like Lightning Bolt, should have done your response to the Mirror Entity ability to save his Sunspear Shikari. Or it's just a brute force. Yeah, I'm very happy that I top 5. Oh, it's double brute force. Yeah, sure. Alright, so he doesn't have any cards in his hand. Now we'll get back this forest. And then cast this Ethersnipe. And Laractus Carnarium. drew Tutsworth's Gambit. Why do you play that card? And the Cathodian. Sure. What I'm gonna do is just attack with a 4/4 and then cast a Manta 5/5 and the Demir Guildmage. I don't think I can do all of these right. No, the Manta won't be. If I wanna cast the Guildmage, Manta cannot be 5/5. I don't know, let's stop all of these. No, it can be. Yeah. And I think this will do it. So yeah, very quick game one, I assume, yeah. And now I'm boarding all the creatures that I have in my sideboard. The 2-1 Wither. What will I board out? The Drake for sure. What else? No, so I wanna board those in. How many swamps do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, probably I'm gonna switch a mountain for a swamp. Maybe a plains. Yeah, and I'm board this purge now, and I don't wanna board the purge. Plains, I have 2. Yeah, I'm boarding out the plains for a swamp here. And I need to cut another card for this 2 sickle ripper. Necrogenesis can be the cut. Yeah. No, it's this is good. Lorsket Cotla, it's probably very expensive. I mean, it's a very slow. Now I think I just bought 1 Sickle Reaper and that's it. And yeah, the planes can be cut. Yeah, sure. Alright. This end is a keep. So once again, on the draw, with this end, I don't really want to go to discard. Hope to draw, yeah, it's fine. That or the Wayfarer Bubble, or even this member. Alright, so we can play this Etched Oracle right now. Also the Comet Storm this time, we can play it. Seems good in this matchup. He has a cheap creature that I can target multiple times. Let's see what's lead with Vyashino Slaughtermaster. So yeah, probably Celestial Purge needs a slot here. With drawing the forest, I cannot play Etched Oracle as a 4/4 next turn, which is kind of bad. I think I'm just gonna play this Mirror Entity since I nothing else to do, and this the Mirror Aqueduct. It's gonna deal me 2. Alright. And what's better, the Mirror Aqueduct or Chancery? I think Aqueduct is better. Take back the forest. I cannot block anything, so I'm just gonna take 4. 5-5-4-4. Oh, Blending Solitaire, is it a good draw? So Etched Oracle here, let me block something. But I'm gonna take 5. How many mana do I have? I have 5 mana, so I can... How does this work? Yeah, I can kill these two creatures right now that is tapped out and can't Apostle Blessing or anything like that. Yeah, this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take 5 here, go to 9. But yeah, then I can deploy Necrogenesis and put some blockers for that. So yeah, I'm gonna cast No Comet Storm. Choose as many number of target creature and players. 1 and 2. Okay. So now pay X. X is currently 2. I don't know how this works. Don't think it works this way, right? Yeah, no, it doesn't. Sorry, okay, now I got how this works. See, it does this. Okay. Pay X. Okay. Okay, and then tap 3. All right. And then I just pass. Take 5, go to 9. Heather Snipe here. Heather Snipe here can be good. I can Heather Snipe one of the 5/5. Then, oops. Then I can also double block, I think. So the other one cannot comes into play with the 2+2+2 counters. And even if he force brute that, a 5/5, I can keep it low with the Necrogenesis and the other stuff. So yeah, I'm just gonna run the risk. Alright, so it doesn't have anything, so just a 2-for-1 and the Cthulhu. And the kit sale. Huh. The kit sale, I didn't want to see it. How many mana do you have? 3/6. So I cannot play Necrogenesis and... So okay, what I'm gonna do is just cast this Necrogenesis and Blinding Soul Eater. Then Azorius Chancery, a forest. This may be a mistake, because now he can also not keep. Yeah, no, he had mana, so he would have done that. I could have also played the Etched Oracle. To yeah, so now I will tap the creature with the kit sail on. Unfortunately, I have only Azorius Chancery, so this will take me. Yeah, I'm gonna do this. Cast Oracle. Then tap this one. Block. Put a token. This is tough because if I wanna put a token to block the Minotaur, then I can suffer Burst Lightning here and don't draw cards. Because I will be tapped out. Otherwise, I can just chump block here and draw 3 cards. Which is probably the safer option. Yeah, this is what I'm gonna do. The point is that he doesn't have anything, because otherwise he would have just killed these. Oh no, no. Yeah, he would have killed these. So yes, to me, he doesn't have a burst lightning or a way to deal with the oracle. So I'm happy to charm block here and off to on top with the mana left for etched oracle. There's two cards in his hand, very likely they are just one creature, one land. Let's see. Bloodshot Trainee. Alright. Alright. Ear Servant. So this let me tap down the trainee, but then I can't tap that. Yeah, but at this point I just tap the Bloodshot Trainee and the charm block here with the token. So yeah, I got play this for sure. Then I just pass. Let's see. That's right, Gambit. So he has a 6/6, but that doesn't change many things. So once again, I will tap this down and put a token in play without having the mana on top for Etched Oracle. Oh no, I tapped the wrong one. It is a misclick. So yeah. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna put the creature as well. Yeah, this was a very big misplay, because now I need to trade with the trainee. I can't afford to go to 2. Desert Servant would be great, but yeah, this point I just need to block. I can't play around the to scare me, sure. Yeah. I didn't play well at all. Yeah, sure, I'll pass the turn here. I wanna leave Etched Oracle back for Cathodian. Even though now he's gonna keep Kit Sail and attack me. Yeah, this was so bad. This misclick was very bad. Will punish me very hard. He has 2 Brute Force in his deck. But I don't know if he can afford to pump a creature that I can draw 3 cards in response and just find a way to deal with it. I'm very disappointed for the turn before. It's just gonna pass. Here I can draw end of turn. But first I wanna suck the bubble to draw less land, take a swamp. Oh yeah, I already played the Comet Storm, so yeah, you don't need double red anymore. Alright, I'm dead. Very disappointed. Could have easily won this game. So yeah, we are 1-1, but final round, final match, final game. What do we want? We can want Plummet. Chested Purges, of course, goes in. Probably Core Reaper doesn't worth anymore, and switch back the planes for the swamp. Yeah, that's it. Play first, yes I do. Keep, yes. Think I'm gonna play the the point is that if he plays a 2-drop and I cast Blinding Soul Eater. Yeah, sure, I'm gonna play this Chancery so that I will have white mana for activated on turn 4. I'm gonna play whatever and just say, oh, Kite Sail. It's a good drop. I'm not going to cast Etched Oracle until I have one mana up. We can't play the 1-1 double strike, so I can play Cathodian. No, it's a Tesseract Gambit. Yeah, that's okay. I think I'm gonna deal 1 damage here. Let's see, he's 4 mana, a lot of cards in his hand. I figured that he has a creature right now. It's a Sunspear Shikari, that's great. Because now if he equips it, I will Grim Affliction that. Yeah. Now I'm gonna cast this Etched Oracle, leaving red mana on top. And keep attacking. And then I can also play this 3-3-4-4, which is very bad, but it's in our deck. Slick Slicer, now its name is Slick. Sickle Slicer. If he keeps it. Alright, I don't wanna burst lightning that. Just don't care. Attack with the Nest Invader. Sorry, the Etched Oracle. And cast the Nest Invader. Rather than the. Yeah, I can also wait another turn to draw a forest. And cast it bigger. All right, I'm gonna tap the germ down. Let's see what it is. Terashi Grasp. Gonna gain 3 life here. Alright, so it doesn't have much going on. I still don't wanna cast this burst lightning here. Just keep bashing for like 6 and then cast this. I don't know, I prefer casting this Nest Invader, yeah. Even though, so let's count a bit. We put him on 9, and this is 6 plus 3. Yeah, so this Gnarled Puck would be lethal next turn. Yeah, might as well cast this one. Just pass. So we cast our Hill Giant that appeared to be lethal. Bolt. Okay, so it's not lethal anymore. He drew finally his second white, so now can deploy. I don't even know his name, is the 1/1 double strike for 3. He has 3 cards in his hand. And finally, play that. Yeah, sure. Not gonna cast Burst Lightning because if it doesn't block, I'm lethal. Oof. Yeah, the point now counts that. I don't mind. Alright. So, he might have Brute Force. So, I'd rather attack him with Etched Oracle. Or with both. Put him on 7. Then these are 7 points of burn. Do we have all the mana? Yeah, sure. So yeah, attack with both. And that'll do it. 5 color burn. I can't imagine him having some way to gain life. Cast with the Kicker because why not? And yes, so we triggered the draft and hope you enjoyed the 5 color deck. And yeah, bye bye.